Thank you. Okay, guys, so this is gonna be a pretty probably lengthy talking clip than I normally do. So yesterday was the tournament, as you guys saw, because this is a continuation of whatever. Anyways, as you guys saw, yesterday was the Special Olympics tournament, and I was in a very weird state of mind, I guess. I was extremely frustrated the entire day for the most part. Each tournament that we do is hosted by a different group of people. And sometimes they host a good meet, sometimes they host a bad meet, sometimes they host an okay meet. And so, not being biased, but the meet that we host every single year, which is the first tournament of the year, is, in my opinion, the best meet run. It's always run smoothly, everybody knows what they're doing. The last tournament we had, I told you guys, was just a disaster when it came to organization and whatnot. And this tournament I've been to 4 years in a row, and it's normally run, pretty well, but for some reason yesterday, it was run differently, and because of it, I missed a lot of things. I was really trying to focus on filming to make the edit that I did, and I missed a whole bunch of stuff. I missed people getting awards. I missed people competing in their running events, their field events. I missed the entire first basketball game, the first half of the last basketball game, and because of that, it kind of got me in a bad mood, just because I was missing a lot of things, and which also got me thinking, is it really worth filming all this stuff and missing what's really going on? And we have the big Summer Games tournament coming up in 2 weeks, and I don't know if I'm going to be filming that or if I'm just gonna go and enjoy it, because it's already hard enough trying to go back and forth between basketball and track and trying to juggle between seeing everybody and not seeing everybody and all that kind of stuff, and then try to film on top of that. It just, you miss a lot of things because you're looking through the camera and you're not really watching what's going on. And at the last game I went to for the basketball, the last half I didn't even film, and I enjoyed it way more than I did. And then I got home, and just the whole past 2 weeks just caught up to me and hit me hard, and I was just exhausted, and I just fell asleep. I was out for like 3 hours, and then when I woke up, I was all groggy and everything, so I didn't film at all after the tournament. I did my push-ups that I will probably have put somewhere in here, or I'm going to put it in now. But I did my push-ups, and then I went to bed, and that was about it, and then went on to today, and then, yeah. So yesterday was just a very off day for me, extremely off day for me. I was frustrated with how much I missed. I was exhausted, I was just tired and groggy and all that kind of stuff, so I just didn't feel like talking in front of the camera at all. Even during the push-ups, I didn't want to say, oh, I'm going to do push-ups now, and then, oh, I'll see you guys tomorrow. So that's why yesterday's portion of the video was so short, but I hope you guys all enjoyed the edit. That might be the last edit for the season for Special Olympics if I decide not to do an edit for the Summer Games, but we'll see how I feel about that. And then today, I went to the gym this morning. I planned on sleeping in today because I almost never get sleep in, and I woke up at 8 o'clock and I couldn't feel lack of sleep. So I was like, I'll take advantage of that. I'll just get my day started early because I have a lot of work I need to get done anyways. So I went to the gym. I went to World Gym, hit a back and bicep workout. I filmed everything. I did the first one of the variations of the hammer strength pull downs. I did 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps with that one. Moved into the seated hammer strength rows, 4 sets, 8 to 10, I believe. Yeah, it was 8 to 10. And then I went into the bent over rows, did 4 sets, 8 to 10 of that one as well. Then I finished off my back movements with a lat pull down, did 4 sets of 6 to 8 reps. And it's nice switching it up, going to World Gym, because they have different machines that Mission Fitness doesn't have. And then I also kind of switch up the orders too, as well, which is also a good thing to do when it comes to working out. Is if you're going to do the same move, if you're always going to do the same movements, at least try to switch up the order, switch up the sets, switch up the rep range, all that kind of stuff, just to kind of trick your body into other things. And then I moved into 2 bicep movements. I did seated curls and then seated hammer curls. Both were 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps. And then I did cardio. Up to cardio today. So I did 40 minutes of cardio, which is the longest session I've done. I did 35 minutes of running, 5 minutes of walking. So just longest cardio session in general, and then longest running portion of the cardio I've done yet. And then I did a little physique-ish update, I guess. I had a little back pump going on, so I wanted to kind of show that off. I was at the gym for a lot longer than I thought I was going to be. That's just getting all caught up with what's going on. So that's why yesterday's video was so short, and then now we're here right now. I'm feeling better today. Hopefully I will continue on with the vlog a lot better this time around than I did yesterday. And then I'm also going to be working with my dad today on this cabin we built a few years back. He put in an AC unit, but now he has to do electrical work, and he's gonna teach me the electrical stuff. So I'll show you guys the cabin, and I'll show you guys like a time lapse of us working together. I'm actually having my post-workout meal right now, so I'll show you guys that in just a second. Okay, so for my post-workout meal, I'm having 3/4 servings of my egg whites, and then 2 servings of ketchup with that, so that's right there. And then I'm gonna have some veggies. I have 2 servings of the broccoli cauliflower carrot mix, and then 2 servings of this riced broccoli cheddar mix. So it's like the Thai curry carrots, but it's broccoli instead with like a cheddar seasoning. Actually tastes pretty good. So I just have to mix that up, but that's it right there, the thing that looks like vomit. And then I'm also having a Powerade Zero, the blue one, because blue's my favorite color. It's awesome. That's honestly how I choose a lot of drinks. If I've never had before, I always go with the blue just because I like blue. So I'm gonna enjoy this, and then I'm going to, I think, work with my dad before I get to, yep. I'm gonna enjoy this, and then probably work with my dad on the cabin before I get started on some videos and some schoolwork. So this is the cabin that my dad and I built a few years back. It was a huge project that took, I think, about like 3 months to do. So it wasn't like a kit or anything like that. It was actually his own design he made, and then we just bought pieces, and then got to work. So this is what it looks like on the inside. So my dad likes the log cabin type feel, so he wanted to make it like a log cabin. So this is how it looks. And this is what we're gonna be working on today. It's working right now, but it's hooked up to an extension cord, and we're gonna actually learn, oh, I'm gonna learn the electrical wireless stuff so we can get that just going. This is it though. Built with our 2 hands. So it's pretty cool, and then it's actually really nice to hang out. Got a little TV over there, little fake fireplace for a heater. So nice little area, and now we're gonna get to work on some electrical stuff. Oh, space. We just got all the wiring stuff done. All right, so we got all the electrical stuff taken care of, and now I'm gonna get to work on some school, on some editing, and as a treat, and I'm very excited to have this, I am having Fruity Pebbles. So I have 3 servings of Fruity Pebbles and 1.5 servings of the cashew milk, and I am looking forward to this. This right here is the perks of flexible dieting. I normally only do this stuff on the weekends just because I can wait later on in the day to eat my food. So looking forward to this, and I will catch you guys all when I have free time. Okay guys, so end of the night. I got a lot of work done today, but still have so much work left. The school year is coming to an end in 2 weeks. It's crunch time for school, crunch time for the diet, everything. To recap tonight, all I did was worked on homework, worked on a couple videos, then I had some dinner. I had my egg white sandwiches with 2 yogurts, and I also made the protein ice cream, and then I also got my food ready for tomorrow. So I actually ran out of the broccoli cauliflower carrot mix, so I just did, instead of that, I used the buffalo cauliflower, mixed that up with the carrots, the Thai curry carrots, 6 ounces of the chicken, had some carrots packed up, I have some beef jerky packed up. And let's see, and tomorrow's going to be refeed day, so I'm going to figure out what I'm going to have. I know that I'm going to eat my amazing Quaker crackers, the caramel ones, so we'll have that already ready for tomorrow, all set up. So, got a lot done tonight, just has a lot more I got to get done still, so I'm going to do push-ups now, get ready for bed, then tomorrow's the 5 a.m. day, so got to be up early. So, here we go, push-ups. For today, hope you guys all enjoyed it. If you guys haven't already, please like, share, subscribe. Thank you all for watching. I have like 13 days left, I think. It's 13 or 12 days left, so very excited. And I've been waiting around, I keep waiting at 140 point something. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I've been up in the cardio the past couple times, so hopefully my weight will drop and stay 139s. I'm hoping maybe like, I guess in the 138s or 137s possibly, but then this cut would be pretty good, so we'll see what happens. But yeah, like I said, if you guys haven't already, please like, share, subscribe. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you guys all on the next one.